Hi friends, welcome back to my channel. Thank you so much for choosing to spend your social media currency with me today and watch this video. Today we are packing my good old beautiful pink Hulken bag. This is the medium size Hulken for those of you who have never seen a Hulken bag. It's pretty big and it is going to fit all of this stuff that I thrifted yesterday at the Goodwill outlet for Plato's Closet. I specifically picked these items up. Well, let me fix my shirt. Specifically picked these items up to settle Plato's Closet. My particular Goodwill outlet costs $1.69 a pound. So editing me will put on the screen what I spent in total yesterday at the bin. So for everything I just picked up and tried to show you all of the things that we are selling to Plato's today, as well as what's on the rolling rack behind me. This is prepped and ready for me to film a bins haul for you guys. I know we haven't had a bins haul in a week or so, but one is coming, I promise. I'm not sure if you're going to be seeing this haul or this Plato's video first. I think it might be this Plato's video, but I promise the next video will be the other haul. Anyway, let's get into packing this Plato's bag. So this is going to be the first time I'm doing two Plato's Closet videos in 1 week. Typically, I go to Plato's twice a week. I just don't make content out of going every time. Don't take them the same things over and over again. I just feel like that's a little redundant, like waste of my time, waste of their time. In most cases, there's a specific reason that things are passed on. Like there's a stain that maybe you didn't notice, that they noticed, that they're not going to take this item because it's flawed, or it's a style they just won't take. Like earlier this week, I brought them a cute little cropped animal print like tank top, and the girl told me at the counter when we were like cashing out and they were like telling me what they bought, purchased, and what they liked versus what they passed on, she specifically said to me, she looked me dead in my eyes and goes, "Yeah, animal print's really not in style anymore." Eat some humble pie over here by myself, okay? So they will never take that likely. If I brought them that animal print tank top again, although it's a cropped little lightweight summery tank top, they probably would pass on it again because it's animal print, just point blank. So there's no use in having that take up room in my bag, having that take up, you know, valuable space in my bag that could be filled with other items they might say yes to. Also, I can imagine it would get annoying for employees to have to look at the same stuff over and over again that they know they can't take in, and then turn around and have to tell you as a seller, "Sorry, we couldn't take any of your things. They're not in style." Like, nobody wants to tell you that, but they're also running a business. I don't know. We're doing the Plato's Closet dance today. I don't know what else to say about it, but hopefully these videos can help fine tune. Maybe if you are a bin shopper and you also sell to Plato's, maybe this can give you a little bit idea. Maybe something you might see and pick up for them that you might not have before. Anyway, let's get into it now that I've rambled on for 5 minutes now. Okay, first thing. Also, I put things in the bag, kind of like filter them in. I won't put like all of the jeans stacked one on top of the other, or all of the t-shirts, or all of the activewear, because I feel like it's less interesting that way, and I want to make it as interesting and fun and exciting for the person doing my buy as possible, because then they have to go and turn around and enter all that into the computer, and then they probably have to tag it all and then hang it all in the store or put it in back stock, X, Y, and Z. So all the things that you're buying for me, I want you to be like excited about as you can be, I guess, for lack of a better term. Anyway, first thing, I think this is going to be, oh, also, right here on the screen, as I'm putting the items in the bag, I will let you know if Plato's purchased or passed on the item, and then we will jump to a clip where I read you the itemized receipt, hopefully with the prices and the brand names, so we can get a better idea of exactly what I was paid out for each item. Okay, now we're really going to pack the bag. This is a ultra soft, like, it almost feels like Skims, Spanx, and Lululemon had a baby, if that makes sense. American Eagle little like body suit top, except it's not a bodysuit. It's like a really tight like bodycon top, and it's this like really nice neutral color. I think this is going to for sure be a yes. Next, we have a brand new skirt, and this is a linen blend H&M skirt. Really cute little like resort wear, high slit midi skirt. Thing to note when I'm looking for things for Plato's Closet, the boxes that need to be checked are, is it cute? Number one. Is it lightweight? Number two. And number three, is it a brand that they may recognize or they like or they care about? Because I feel like brand is something for Plato's Closet that comes secondary to the looks or the style of the garment. They will buy something in based on what it looks like Shein, for example, over it being a good brand name, in my opinion anyway. At least at my Plato's Closet, I've said this a million times before, they love Shein, and then they'll have high-end things priced not so high because it's either not in their system, and Plato's Closet as a franchise doesn't care about this brand. So when they type in the brand name and nothing comes up, they just have to put it as women's brand or men's brand and then price you out based on their scale that way. So cute, lightweight, is it a brand they might know? Those three boxes I like to check off in my brain when I'm sourcing for Plato's. Next, really cute little ribbed American Eagle crop top, and this is white. I think that will be a yes too. Next, I mean, I hope all of these things are a yes, but these are really cute PacSun. What are they? The boyfriend jean. I'm gonna stay away from mom jeans from now on since I brought them two pairs of mom jeans on Monday and they passed on them and they're both American Eagle. So maybe mom jeans are out, but these are the boyfriend jean and these are from PacSun. Then I have this. This is a experimental piece for Plato's. This is the brand. It's a little activewear dress. I really like this like kind of crazy like hurt your eyeballs pattern, but it has this little like tennis skirt vibes, little ruffle at the bottom. So I think that might be a yes for Plato's Closet. Anyway, that's why I picked it up, because a little ruffle on the bottom. So we will see with that one. Then I have a pair of men's jeans. These are Pierce jeans. I could not find anything about this jean, and I actually bought these to list myself, but like I said, could not find anything about this brand. So to Plato's Closet they go. They're a really nice light wash straight leg fit with no distressing, so I think these might be a yes. Then I have this. This is just a little California graphic t-shirt, men's graphic t-shirt. Looks like somebody ripped the tag off, donated it to Goodwill. Next, a really cute little Etro romper. This is like a little gingham print, little honey and white color, tie waist, shorts situation. Really cute. Next, really cute. I wish these were my size. Nike like salmon pink jogger sweatpants. Absolutely nothing wrong with these. So, so cute. Then a North Face. This is like a little lightweight fleece quarter zip jacket. It's women's. Some Gymshark leggings. These are a full length. And they have the nice big logo there on the waistband. Sorry if you can hear the trash truck. They're about to take our trash. I feel like I always film on trash day. And as soon as I start filming, that's when all the trash trucks come. But hopefully you can't hear them too bad because of my microphone. Anyway, these are a pair of Thread and Supply, new with tags, fake leather leggings. This is so cute. No brand on this one, but this is one that was cute and lightweight, so I was like, awesome. Really fun lemon printed little above the knee skirt. No brand on here, but I think it's extra cute. They may take that, or they may be like, oh, it's too mature. We'll see. Then I found these, and these are, I was excited to find these at the bins, but Good American, but somebody had cut the size tag, I think, unless, oh, they didn't cut it out. Oh, it was just folded under. Dang, that was the only reason I was going to give these to Plato's. I guess I can still give them to Plato's. There are 427 apparently, Good American jeans. But I was going to give them to Plato's because they had no size and I didn't want to just have to list them as C measurements. But We'll give them a try anyway. I would expect to get between $8 and $12 for these, hopefully 12. Next, this little white Nike tank top. This is a women's dry fit tank top. And for being white, it is still in pristine condition, especially for living through the bins. And we have, oh, this is real. I love this color, but I don't like the neckline on this dress for myself. Otherwise, I would probably try it on. This is just an Old Navy little, like, cute cover-up little gauzy cotton dress in this really bright cobalt blue. Oh, my gosh. That's a hard one for me. Cobalt blue. Whatever. That's what we're, you know what I mean. It's Old Navy. It's new with tags, and it's got this little tie neck detail. Really cute. Then we have some more athletic wear, little DKNY black bike shorts. These looked really washed out on camera, but they are in like pristine condition. Not washed out or faded at all. Then I tried this on yesterday. So Jack is graduating from college on Sunday, and I have been looking for an outfit for his graduation. And yesterday I found this dress. This is a Topshop dress. It's a really cute like pink with tiny little Swiss dots all over it. And this really nice like button up detail at the front. This did not fit me, but I found, fingers crossed, on a Target dress. And it's a brighter pink shade than this, which I absolutely love. And I actually really like how it fit me yesterday when I tried it on. So fingers crossed, come Sunday, I still really like it because I've never found an outfit for an event so easily before. And yesterday at the bins, I was just like grabbing all the dresses thinking, okay, try this on. Who cares? Try this on. Wouldn't normally gravitate toward that. We'll try it on. And I can't believe like the second dress I tried on, I really like. Anyway. We actually can't go to Plato's until FedEx arrives because FedEx is bringing the gift I ordered for him and it's signature required, so I have to be here, unfortunately. It says they're supposed to come between 9:40 or 8:40 and 1 o'clock, so hopefully we'll be able to make it to Plato's today. Big shout out to my husband who, like I said, is graduating college this weekend. I'm so proud of you, babe. Congratulations. And please don't ask me what I got you because I'm not going to tell you until Sunday. Okay, back to this. Anyway, really cute Topshop little pink dress. And let me actually button the front of this before I put it in there. That's another thing about Plato's stuff. I always make sure to like button the buttons, zip the zippers, tie the ties, so that when somebody looks at it, they're not like, what is this wonky thing? I don't even know if all the pieces are there. What am I supposed to do with this? Pass, you know? I try to make it like as easy as possible for you to be like, oh yeah, that's really cute. Let me buy that. Like, so let me tie the back of this really quick. Cute. Topshop, if I didn't see that, because I don't remember. Okay, next, Under Armour, new with tags, men's, what is this? Fitted heat gear top, new with tags. Sometimes they buy these, sometimes they pass on them, and I'm not really sure why. Not always a yes, but we will see. Then some Zaya leggings. These are a full length black legging with a little like side stripe down each leg. And they are a size 6-8. I don't know why I just showed you the size because that does not matter. Then I have this hoodie. This is a really cute Laguna brand hoodie. I thought it was much more expensive than it actually is because it has all these little like fun details, like the little ties are like dipped in something and then they have like a colored string on them. I don't know. I thought it was much more expensive than it is and I picked it up for myself to list, but I think a better use of my time is to actually sell this to Plato's and hopefully be a fast flip. Next, we have these. These are a pair of men's Vans, like hybrid nylon athletic shorts. They do have like that diaper liner thing on the inside, but they also look washed out, but they are in really great shape. They're not like faded at all. Then I have this. This was cute and extra lightweight. That's why I picked it up for Play-Dohs. The brand is something I've never heard of. Sky and Sparrow. Here's the tag. It will focus. There we go. And it's just this really cute little sheer mesh micro floral top with like the little cinching in the front. I think that will be a yes. Another new with tags item. This is just a men's graphic t-shirt. Cute little, what brand is this? Huntington BC men's pineapple graphic shirt. New with tags. The last time I was in on Monday, they told me they passed on some of the things because they were too plain and they are looking for graphic things, which I feel like every time I go, I get conflicting information about that. Sometimes it's your stuff's too busy and graphic patterns don't really do well for us. And then the next time I go, it'll be, we're really looking for graphics. You had to pass on some of your stuff because it's too plain. That happens to me and I go to Play-Dohs all the time. So if that happens to you, don't be offended. They're not telling you like your stuff is personally crap. You have personally crap style. It's just what they're looking for their inventory needs, what is selling well for them and what they've been told to purchase in. I feel like it took a while for me to not really be offended, but they're really not trying to offend you. They're just doing their job. American Eagle, little soft and sexy and soft and sexy crop top in like a really nice chocolate brown color. They might tell me that's too plain. And then I found another pair of those Vans activewear men's shorts. These do not have like the little liner on the inside and they're like a washed gray color. These are, I believe, Shein, yes. Shein little boxer shorts. These are like super popular in style right now. The boxer style, if I didn't make that clear. Next, Brandy Helville. Little crop top, it is what it is. Save it from the landfill at least, because Play-Dohs definitely likes Brandy Melville. These are interval leggings. They're really nice, like super, super stretchy, and I like this blue color. I've never heard of this brand before. Oh, these are Level 99, and they are a like cargo jogger style pant. Here's the tag, Level 99. See if they take them. They look faded and washed out on camera too, but these look like somebody literally just ripped the tag off and never wore them. Next I have, stuck on something else, hold on. This dress, it's a boutique brand from this boutique and it's new with tags. It is called the Coachella laced tube dress. So I feel like they might take it for that. But also they may pass on it because it is strapless. We shall see. Hopefully the fact that it's new with tags and kind of like black and gothy and it says Coachella on the tag. Hopefully all those things will help Play-Dohs to be like, yeah, we need that. It's matching cute little like extra cozy Hollister set. This is a little tank top with a matching pants. So hopefully this is a Play-Dohs Closet special. We're getting pretty full now. Okay, what is this? Oh, this is a Shein Easy Wear little, I don't know if this is a dress or a romper. Hold on. Here's the sleeves, the tie shoulders. That's cute. This is a romper. So a little black romper with the tags attached. I have a pair of Champion bike shorts. These also look washed out, but they are basically new without tags. Okay, and then two more things. This is a really cute little Angie, like peasant skirt, little festival skirt. And I think this is definitely a Play-Dohs special. And then last, another new Old Navy dress. I really like the style of this dress. Just a t-shirt dress with like an open back. And I like this really pretty like light pink color. I did not know, excuse me, I did not know Old Navy was that expensive, $36, and that looks like a clearance price for this dress, which is wild to me. I thought Old Navy was a little bit more affordable than that. Coming from someone who shops at the Bins, I guess I don't know what affordable for clothing is. Anyway, we have now filled this Hogan to the brim, and now we are going to wait on FedEx and then make our way to Plato's. If FedEx comes early enough today, I am going to go to Plato's right after they come. So hopefully this video can go up today. This clip will be a clip of me in the car, hopefully, fingers crossed, reading you the itemized receipt for all of the things that Plato's purchased. Okay, let's go make some money. Hi friends, so we just picked up at Plato's. I got 89.10, and yes, I said that right, 89.10 for 14 items, which is great. I think I spent 73 in total for everything I got at the Bins that day, so I will take 89 all day long. It's wonderful. Let's find out what they purchased. Well, you already know what they purchased. I don't know yet. Let's find out what they paid me for each item. Women's PacSun jeans, $7.60. Men's other brand t-shirt, $4.20. American Eagle tank top, $4.90. Nike Dry Fit tank, $4.90. Women's North Face Heavy, $11.40. Good American Denim, $12. I think that's exactly what I said I was hoping to get for those. DKNY shorts, $6.08. Vans shorts, $6.08. Vans shorts, $4.90. Sky and Sparrow short sleeve, $6.08. Shein short talls, $3.90. Brandy Melville short sleeve, $6.08. Hollister tank top, $4.90. And Hollister pants, $6.08. For a total of 14 items for $89.10. Wonderful. So that's the end of this video. If you took the time to watch, I so appreciate it. And if you wouldn't mind just hitting like on the way out, that would be awesome. I'll see you next time, friends. Bye.